Hello, my name is Andy Melendrez, and I'm your Ward 2 City Council member and also the host of Good Neighbor Riverside. And today we're at the Community Settlement Association here in the Eastside community with a great partnership in our community. Miguel, why don't you take a look at this truck? Hansel Phelps is a contractor in the area. Oh, Dr. Payne, we don't want you to go anywhere. Stay close. But yes, yes, we're here for an excellent partnership. People want to be on camera, Miguel. Go ahead and say hello. These are some of the individuals that are here. A real exciting time here in our Eastside community. Again, Hansel Phelps helped coordinate a turkey giveaway here in our community. A lot of people waiting outside. You want to take a look out there, Miguel? And of course, we have individuals behind us. Many of the volunteers are coming in right now, but you see the many individuals that are waiting to receive their turkey and the fixings for their Thanksgiving dinner. Miguel, let's go ahead and introduce a couple of the individuals that work for the Community Settlement House. And I asked Dr. Payne to wait for me, and he did not wait, so he was on the move. Let's go ahead and look for them and see if we can find them. Let's keep on walking here. And you see the number of people here. There's a lot of people waiting, but the process is working very smoothly. I found somebody. Let's go ahead and take a look over here. And come on over here. I know, Ninfa, you're shy. I need you to introduce yourself and tell us what you do.
My name is Ninfa Delgado, Vice President of Operations, Chief Operating Officer for Riverside Community Health Foundation.
And tell us about this partnership.
We entered into this partnership with Community Settlement Association in May of 2016 into a management agreement where we now manage the operations of Community Settlement Association. However, Community Settlement Association remains its own nonprofit entity with its own mission.
And the work that you're doing here today with Hansel Phelps, looks like you have Melina in there. Tell us a little bit about that.
Hansel Phelps actually came into partnership with Community Settlement Association a few years ago and has graciously provided turkeys for our families at Community Settlement. And last year, after our event, we entered into another partnership with Molina Healthcare, and this year they're providing all the trimming. So now our families have a complete Thanksgiving dinner that they can have this year.
Great, and this partnership here has gone on for 3 years now. As I understand.
Yes.
Great. And how does CSA, Community Settlement Association, feel about that?
Oh, well, it's amazing. There's a lot of new partnerships that have started. If you have not been to Community Settlement Association lately, please do. We do have a new senior director for Community Settlement Association who joined us in about March this year. And there have been a lot of changes. There's a lot of activity at the Settlement House and really trying to make sure that we're serving the needs of the community and that it remains as the place that the Settlement House has always been in the Eastside neighborhood.
Great. Well, thank you so much. We see Dr. Payne over here. I didn't want to have to run after him, but he's coming this way. Great. We want to interview him, right? Thank you so much, Ninfa. Take care. Dr. Payne, come out here and join us. Tell us a little bit. This is the director of the Community Settlement Association.
Hello. Who am I speaking with?
You are speaking to the greater Riverside and surrounding community. This will be put on YouTube.
Oh.
So a lot of people are going to take a look.
Now you tell me.
First of all, tell us what you do and give us your name and what you do here.
Sure. Pedro Payne, Senior Director, Community Settlement Association.
Okay. And tell us about this. Ninfa was telling us a little bit about this partnership.
Yes.
How did you get all the people here?
Oh, it's amazing. There's never a shortage of need. There's never a shortage of participation. We do this every year. It's a way to help our community celebrate the holidays, specifically Thanksgiving. We have over 300 families receiving free turkeys today. As you can see, the lines are long and there's even more people waiting outside the gate. And so it's an honor and a pleasure and a privilege for us to be able to, you know, contribute, help out, and meet the need where it's at. And so what can I say? We have also Hansel Phelps, the company. Yep. Hansel Phelps. Yep. Helping us out, Molina Healthcare, and others from Riverside Community Health Foundation. So it's a beautiful partnership. It's an opportunity for us to give back.
Now the people just don't show up. They have to qualify.
They have to qualify too.
I mean, these are individuals that are
low income or homeless. They qualify through our food pantry program. We do have a food pantry program. We provide food Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays. And that's an income-based program. It's free, but it's income-based. So to qualify for that, you obviously have to be considered low income or 200% below poverty line. And once they qualify for that program, then we go ahead and make the advertisement, or we market this event along with others. But this specific event, they have to qualify through that program. So we know that all the folks that are receiving turkeys here today are either low income or homeless.
Okay. And you do a great job in coordinating this. It seems like everything is running very smoothly.
Looks can be deceiving. Well, thank
it
you.
It looks like
thank
it's
you.
Running very, very well.
We are so
well.
Organized and so coordinated. Yes, yes. Why would you think different?
Because everybody's running smoothly in and out. It looks like you have a great group of staff members over there
yes.
working in coordination with the Community Settlement House. Miguel, just take a very quick look around it
yes.
so we can look at the number
and
of individuals.
When is it? Community yeah. volunteers that just come out and they see a beautiful thing happening and they want to be a part of it.
Yeah.
So.
And there are more people waiting outside the gate and they'll be coming in groups. I guess they have a time that
yes.
they come in.
We have 15-minute blocks, as you can see, and so we start, you know, 9:15, 9:30, 9:45. So to crowd control, make sure that they are able to flow through the facility in an efficient manner.
Great.
And then at 11 o'clock, we start our waiting list. We actually had a waiting list this year. So we did the first 300 half time slots, and then after that is a waiting list. We'll give out those turkeys. If there are more turkeys still left over, we'll give those out to whomever is out there waiting. And we'll try to hopefully, you know, everyone that comes here walks away with a turkey today.
Wow. It, you know, great coordination between Hansel Phelps,
yes.
who collects all the food,
yes.
Molina Healthcare,
yes.
who's also
and,
all
yeah,
the trimmings.
Plates and, yes, exactly.
And then the Community Settlement Association.
The Community Settlement Association. We provide the facility. We provide the clientele. And Riverside Community Health Foundation, of course, who is our partner and our parent organization. And without them, this couldn't happen.
Right. Well, thank you so much for all the work you're doing.
Welcome.
I'll let you get back to work.
Thank
I'm glad
you.
I got you for
all
this
right.
much time.
Thank you.
Thank you,
everyone.
Dr. Payne. Take care. So there you have it. A lot of coordination, a lot of commitment to individuals, helping individuals in need here in the city of Riverside. Thank you for joining us. We'll see you next time.